my warehouse where all the magic happens, and this is where I'm going to be giving the class, the teachable moment. We are in National City, San Diego County, California. So I'm literally like 20 minutes away from Mexico. Yes, you guys do have to visit. I'll take you for some good tacos and beer. Thank you, having a party, the whole team, the whole family, for considering Lux and Balloons for a segment in Teachable Moments. We are honored. Thank you. You guys want to see it right now? Okay. This is, okay, we keep it raw, genuine. This is what you get, okay? Keep in mind, it's Friday before the madness, okay? This is not how it looks on Mondays. All right, so behind me, we have a very aesthetic wall full of containers and all the balloons, okay? And we have a mirror closet to make the warehouse feel, you know, bigger. All right, so here we kind of have all of our backstops. So today, yes. So quick recap of what I'm going to be teaching today. I'm going to do an ice, okay. Surprise. Ooh. Yes. They're going to have to tune in. Yes. Awesome. Oh, thank you guys so much for this opportunity. Woo, let's do it. You guys are firing me up. I'm like, let's get it. It's Friday. Woo. No. Awesome. Everybody that's signed in right now, make sure to follow Having a Party, because the Teachable Moment will be happening on their platform, on their Instagram. So make sure to head over there, and I will see you in a couple seconds. All right, let's head over to Having a Party, you guys. Okay, let me drink some water first, because homegirl's gonna be doing a lot of talking right now.
Are you gonna be by yourself, or are you gonna be with them?
No, this is by myself now.
Okay.
Let me see what type of filters they have to make a girl feel and look beautiful.
So everybody here on Pinterest and TikTok, we are going to be showing how to do a balloon cone. It's going to be a teachable moment. If you want to say hi, or are you already live?
Yes, I'm already live over here. But they can head over to Instagram.
Yes. Well, they're all here. So.
Oh, okay. All right. Hello. If you were in my life on my Instagram, welcome back. Thank God Having a Party has beautiful filters, because you guys know it's Friday and it gets crazy for us balloon decorators. I'm gonna wait for a little bit of you to start trickling in. First of all, I wanna honor Having a Party for allowing Lux and Balloons to have a segment at Teachable Moments. I love the swag. Thank you for the shirt. Today, during this segment, I'm going to give you guys a special discount code. It's LUX, L-U-X. So make sure to take advantage and use it to shop around with Having a Party. They have like everything you need. Make sure to go check them out if you haven't already. Today, I'm going to be teaching on how to make an ice cream cone structure. I wanted to do something fun, something different, you know, be ready for the summer. Or if there's like a Candyland theme or any sweet theme, ice cream party, whatever it is, then you guys will know how to do that already. In the past, I've had it where it's like regular event with garland, and then the mom or the client wants to add the ice cream cone. So it's a nice little touch. It's super cute. Hi, Melina. Thank you for tuning in. I'm gonna be fixing this.
Are you starting to move?
Okay, I might need Carlos to take over right now, just because you guys will get a better quality of the video when it's facing the other way, because I can't be moving stuff and teaching at the same time. And then he will be, Carlos will be the one letting me know all the questions that you guys have, okay? And during the teachable moment, I will tell you everything that I'm using. If you guys have any questions, because this is like so second nature to me, I want to make sure I don't like overlook or miss anything, any question that you guys may have, okay? Hello, hello. Where are you visiting from? We are in National City, California, San Diego County, very close to Mexico. All right, okay. Charlie, take over. Charlie, Carlos. All right. He's gonna be taking this, and you could take the charger as well.
Okay.
And then let me know once you can see all of me, so I can start teaching them. Yeah, okay. Say hi, Carlos.
Hello, everyone. I'm gonna flip the camera here. Right here. Perfect. You are
there. I'm good. Start
you
teaching.
Are good.
All right. So again, thank you all for tuning in for Teachable Moments with Having a Party. Today, with Lux and Balloons, you're gonna learn how to make an ice cream cone. So what you're gonna need is 11-inch balloons. You could use mocha or any color you wanna do. The cone. I'm gonna be doing the cone with blush from Qualitex. And for the scoop, I'm going to be using rose from Qualitex. And then I'm going to be doing sprinkles with 260. So I've been getting this question a lot. How do I make the sprinkles? So you're going to need 260s. These are from Qualitex, different colors. I mean, if you really think about it, sprinkles come in a ton of different colors. I'm actually missing white, so if Carlos can find me some white 260s. They're right there. That would be great. Thank you so much.
Said the volume is kind of low.
Oh, maybe my phone.
Oh, you know what? The you
it's pressing it
exactly it?
Oh, I'm so sorry, guys. Thank you for pointing that out.
It was all the way up.
Yeah.
So
okay,
maybe
put putting both of
yeah.
them on. Okay, let me put both AirPods on. Because I'm being pretty loud, right?
Yeah, you're pretty good. They can't hear me, so ask if you are they're able to listen to you.
Okay, can you guys hear me now?
Yeah. I can't hear.
Better?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. You're gonna have to speak up because I can't hear anything.
Okay, I'll scream.
Perfect. You sound like far away, like in an airplane. All right. Okay, guys. So like I was saying, for today's teachable moment, we're gonna be needing 11-inch balloons. Today I'm specifically using Qualitex, but you could use any other brand. I'm gonna be using 260s, manual pump, blue dashes from ProTape, a balloon inflator, and 5-inch balloons. If you have a column stand, even better. And if I forgot anything, I will make sure to point it out. So I got a little head start with the cone part. So there's a lot of different ways you can achieve this look, but my preference are these sizes. So you are gonna start with two quads of 11-inch balloons sized to 6 inches. The next quad is gonna be an 11-inch balloon sized to 6.5 inches. The next two quads are gonna be 7 inch. From there, the next two quads are gonna be 7.5 inches. After that, the next two quads are gonna be 8 inches, and the last quad is going to be 9 inches.
Show the paper, so.
Okay, this is what we're doing, but I don't want them to see my ugly handwriting.
Oh.
That's what I've been trying to hide. And always, you know, when you have your column, make sure to put a 11-inch balloon at the very top, so when you add your topper, it doesn't pop. For the ice cream scoop, we're using a jumbo. I don't know if I noted that. If not, it's gonna be a 36-inch topper. And of course, in order to size your balloons, you're gonna need a sizer. Please don't make fun of me. This is my baby. I have this sizer since I started Lux and Balloons 4 years ago. But if you want one like this, a Qualitex sizer, make sure you head over to Having a Party, any of the things that I'm using today, you can find at Having a Party. I didn't bring my Conwin with me today. It's been a busy week. So make sure to head over to their website and check out what they have and enter their raffle. Okay, so I'm gonna finish inflating the quad for the balloons. I left off in the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, in the 7-inch quads. So I'm gonna start doing the 7.5 quads. As I'm inflating, please start asking questions, you know, engage with me and let's get to know one another. Let me know where you're from. How did you guys find out about Teachable Moments?
So the comments say, well, that they can hear us, that they love your shirt.
Yes. Okay. Where's my 7.5? Here.
And somebody said, hola chicos, and beautiful person.
Oh, gracias. Qué bueno que dijeron, hola chicos, también hablamos español, así que no se chiven, que no les dé vergüenza. Si tienen una pregunta, inglés, español, la podemos contestar, ¿ok?
Yes, and we are watching from San Antonio, Texas.
Nice.
So you could ask them, I don't know if you can hear me or not, but you could ask them where they're watching from.
Okay, I already did.
Oh, you already did? Okay.
So, as I'm teaching you guys, Carlos, the hubby, he's the one, you know, handling the whole recording of this live. So he'll be letting me know the questions that you guys have.
They're asking what raffle and how do they enter to it?
So they have to go to Having a Party, their Instagram, and then they'll have all the details there.
Got it.
And then also we do have a discount code for this segment. So if you shop, I don't remember the exact hours, but I know it ends tonight. Use the code LUX, L-U-X, to get a discount from them. And then I believe they're also going to be giving like a surprise gift.
At the end, yeah.
If they, you know, place their order.
Okay. They're also asking what brand are the balloons? ¿Qué marca son los globos?
They are Qualatex, son Qualatex. Marca Qualatex. Pero no importa la marca, mientras sean de 11 o 12 pulgadas y midan los globos en el calibrador, va a estar bien. So this one, este, es de 7 pulgadas y media, 7.5 inches. 7.5 inches.
They're asking for the famous question. Where do you get your containers from?
Oh, these, I got them at the Dollar Tree, I believe, a very, very long time ago.
I'm gonna have you here so you could have more.
Oh, my balloons keep falling. Can they see me?
Maybe. I want to move the table
out of the way a little bit.
Yeah, just okay. Like angle.
Angle. Like, all right.
Like that.
That's okay with me.
And then. So they can see the ice cream cone.
Perfect. So it's now taking shape. So I'm using quads, but you can also use a cluster of 5 if you want your ice cream cone to have like a more round look to it. But for purposes of time and simplicity, we're just going to be doing the quads. Obviously, the most important part here is for you to do the correct sizes. And this pole is about like a 5'5" or 5'4". I'm 5'3", so you could kind of see the height.
It says it's a free gift with purchase when you use the code at checkout.
I believe so. I need to read the flyer. I'm so sorry, guys. I have so much on my mind. But if you go to the flyer where it has the teachable moment with Lux and balloons, you'll have the exact information directly from Having a Party.
Got it.
A little bit slow for you guys. It was for us, but it's definitely picking up right now with Valentine's Day and, you know, all the events. We're already starting to get booked all the way to June because of graduations. What is your guys' plan for marketing?
They're saying, hey, from ATL, Atlanta?
Atlanta.
Are you guys saving this life?
Yes. Having a party will have this teachable moment. So you can go back and watch it if you missed anything.
Yes, and I'm also recording it on the camera, and I'm also recording it on TikTok and Pinterest, so it's going to be available in pretty much every platform.
All the platforms. Okay, I'm about to wrap up this section. So the last quad, so this quad is 8 inches. I'm going to do another 8-inch one, and then we're going to finish off with the 9-inch quad. Like I said, this cone is like really skinny. So if you want more of a round look to it, you're gonna need to do a cluster of 5 balloons.
We gotta start recording on the camera.
Batteries running low.
I should be making movies.
Alright. One more quad.
Going close.
What happened?
I'm gonna come in close.
Okay, closer.
So they can see how to size. So when do you stop releasing air for the
sizing? It's a feeling more than knowing, but when you feel that the balloon is barely touching like the edge of the circle.
Okay, you got kind of got a little pause there.
So it's when the balloon, see, like right now it's stuck. So you have to release the air until it just like smoothly goes in and out.
And then how do you attach those duplos?
And then I just twist them in. And I have myself a quad.
Okay. And then how do you attach it to the...
And then I just put it in, so in between the Duplo, and then I just twist one of the balloons, and that's it, and press down.
And you do that same thing for every
single one? Yes, for every single spot, yes. The same process.
I also noticed that there's a pattern.
A pattern?
On the balloons, like two, one, one,
oh,
two.
Oh, yeah, you're just offsetting them. Okay. Yeah. All right, after that, we're gonna add our jumbo scoop.
So if you missed the information on the actual sizes, this live is gonna be recorded, so it's gonna be available to you guys.
All right, can they see what I'm doing? All right, so I'm just gonna tie a 260 around the jumbo.
Everybody's able to see me on the other lines.
Oh. It's okay. So they can see all the hard effort and work you put. Oh my god, I just realized I'm gonna need a little step stool. It's over there, the black one.
I'll get it for you.
Okay, so but first, let me show them how I add the jumbo. So like any other column, you're gonna grab your 260, fold ends, and bring it down. Try to center it as much as you can. And just start twisting into any of the balloons, into any of the quads. Doesn't matter, like, which one, what way, and then you're just gonna make a knot, two knots, one and two. Okay. So there's the topper, and then Carlos is gonna go get me the stool, and I'm gonna be adding the little
where's the stool?
It's like the side of the scoop, the little bubbles.
The spring.
Those are not the sprinkles.
Oh.
If you guys have a name for it, let me know.
The crust of the cone?
Because I don't even know it in Spanish. Okay, so these are just 5-inch balloons. I made them into quads and then I tied them neck to neck. I approximately have, currently have about 16 of them. And I wanted to show you just how I add them. So here I have just a regular quad. I'm gonna grab one of the necks of each of the quads and then just tie them. Okay, and that's that process you repeat for all of them. So now I'm gonna see if this is enough. It might be long enough, I don't know if it's short. And this one, you don't need to size it. Okay, maybe Carlos, you need to assist me. I don't wanna make a fool of myself. So you can grab the other end. Yes, it fits. So it did fit, and the same thing, both ends, we're just gonna tie them neck to neck. And there you go. Okay, but we're not done yet. We are gonna add some fun, cute sprinkles. This one's so cute. And it's really big. I'm 5'3", so this thing is probably, what, like 7 feet?
No, probably like eight.
Eight? Oh. Yeah, that's true. So like this. Right? So for the ones that have a hole on each end, I just make a little knot. That. This one as well. Okay. Now we're just gonna pump some air in.
Closer over here, a different angle here.
Okay. All right. Okay. And then honestly, it's just gonna depend on the size you want your sprinkle. I like them to be smaller and medium size. I don't like them to look like a huge sausage, like just this one long thing. All right. And then the ends, I just cut them off so I could get the cleanest look possible.
About hiding the mechanics
all the time. And this, because of the static, they always like just stick to my body. It's so annoying. Okay.
Somebody said love it.
Okay, so this one, since it's the tip of the 260, you don't have to do the knot. Well, yeah, there you go. Here you go. I thought they said good choice of music.
No, they said good choice of music, but because of the music.
Got it.
So, people are asking how much would you charge for this cone?
So, pricing, it's very subjective, depending on where you live, what your overhead is. I know that when we were working from home, I was able to be a little bit more flexible with my pricing. But obviously, depending on different factors, the colors, if they want them double stuffed, standard, where we're delivering to, I would charge anywhere between $175 to $200 just for the structure, and then I would charge delivery and pickup as well. Before, I used to charge for structures, I believe I used to charge like $150, but obviously because of, you know, inflation and a lot of other factors, the price had to go up.
Nice. It says, how many days in advance are you able to make this balloon ice cream?
Because of the sprinkles. Okay, without the sprinkles, I would say 3 to 4 days and, you know, bag it. But the sprinkles, I have found that 260s tend to deflate before round balloons. So the 260s, I would probably inflate them a day before or the day of. But for all of these other balloons, I would do it 3 to 4 days in advance.
Somebody asked, why did you start this business?
Why? Okay, so they're asking me, why did I start this business? Get ready for story time. That's so funny. Oh, did I drop something? No, I didn't. We started Lux and Balloons back in 2019, at the beginning of 2019, because I had just had my second daughter. We have two daughters, a 9-year-old and a now 4-year-old. But back then I had a 5-year-old and a 2-month-old. And I was working for corporate. I know a lot of you can relate to that, you know, with our mama hearts, we want to stay at home with their children and still be able to provide. It's not cheap to live in the United States, so, especially now in California. So I have always had a like knack and an interest for decorating events, but in all honesty, balloons were never really in my radar. But just, you know, the whole aspect of it. So with my firstborn, I would always do the most in her parties, and I just loved the whole creative process. I initially wanted to be an event planner, but quickly realized that that would not be a good idea, because I feel that being an event planner, just, you know, it's a little bit more responsibility and a little bit more stressful. So I just wanted to focus on one thing. And then I was on Instagram one day and I started like seeing all these other decorators from, so I'm here in California, I started seeing decorators from Canada and Australia and seeing all of it, until I was having a conversation with God. I'm a believer, I believe in God, and I asked him, like, you know, God, you know my heart, and I want to do something. I want to be able to stay at home. So these are glue dots, okay? I'm grabbing the Kotex glue dots. You can find these at having a party. I'm going to start adding them to my sprinkles. And I asked them, you know, just highlight to me what I should do. What is my next step in life? You know the desires of my heart. I want to be able to provide, yet stay with my daughters at home. And then balloons came up to my mind. I was like, balloons? I didn't even know balloon inflators. The electric inflators, I didn't even know those existed. So, anywho, I was like, all right, we're gonna do this. And I start looking for classes. I don't find any in my area, not even in Mexico, until I found an instructor in Pomona. And I went to her class. I was 2 months postpartum, breastfeeding and all. But I was like, I'm gonna do it. No excuses. I really wanna do this. I'm gonna do it. I took the whole day to go to her class. It was an amazing class. I was mind blown by her generosity, by her wisdom. And after that, so I'm gonna start adding these. There's no pattern. It could just be random, organic, like just place them wherever you think they look nice. We could put them here at the bottom on the actual jumbo. Oh. If you are scared of heights, then let me tell you, this is not for the faint of heart. And I'm only on a small stool, stepping stool. So, I had an extra one. I could have added it. So I, like I was saying, I took the class. And then shortly after, about 2 months after, you know, thinking all these things about it, I built some courage, I registered the business, we got our Instagram and I just started posting. And when I started getting inquiries from strangers, now family and friends, that were willing to pay for my work, that was just like the moment where like my eyes just like we're open, like, oh my God, we're like really doing this, and this is actually like going to become a business. I just didn't know how big. Honestly, this was just supposed to be a side hustle so I could be home with my daughters. But here we are, 4 years later, thriving, growing, grateful, and loving every step of the process. Woo! And my biggest hype man and cheerleader is right behind the screen. And he doesn't get paid. He does it for free.
Don't matter. Alright, do you transport it all finished or do you build it on site?
Okay, so, great question. Like I said before, we worked from home and we didn't have a commercial van. We had an SUV. We still have that SUV, but we don't use it for work anymore. And we would transport everything in parts. So the actual cone would be by itself. And then this, I mean, it doesn't take up that much space, and the jumbo separately. Or we could have blown up the jumbo on site. So either way, right now we have a commercial van and it fits all of it. We just like put it inside as is. And nothing happens. If anything, the jumbo moves a little bit, but when we arrive to the event, we just fix it and put it in place. If it's too windy, we'll add some glue dots so it could stay, you know, in the same place and not move around. And always add a weight. You don't want your structure, your column falling over.
Next comment or message, it says, I took your online class and learned a lot. Hope to join an in-person one since I'm on the East Coast.
Wow, I know. You know what? Maybe soon, one day, I've talked to Carlos about it. I don't know if you guys, if we get enough interest from a lot of you. Thinking about doing in-person classes in other states. I don't know, maybe tell Joe if having a party would want to have us all the way out there in the East Coast. That's a possibility. That's something that we've been entertaining. But again, I would have to look into it.
A lot of people are saying hi.
Hi?
Yeah, just hi, hello.
Okay, hello.
This was so helpful. I have an event coming up and I was stressing on how to do the sprinkles.
Yay! Glad you can help.
This says, where do you get pathetic pro dot at? But I'm pretty sure that was spell check.
The what? The pro tape glue dots?
It says pathetic, but I'm pretty sure that was spell check.
This one? You can get these at having a party.
The next question says, this is great. Can't wait to make this. A lot of highs and applauses. Says, thank you so much for your knowledge. You guys are a great team. Keep up the great work. We love your story.
Yay. Thank you guys.
Do you take extra balloons in case one pops?
Always. always, I cannot stress that enough. I always say that in my classes. And if you've been my student, you can confirm this. Always take extras. Balloons pop. By nature, they are very delicate and they will pop. So yes, always. So for example, if I were to take this to an event, what am I taking? I'm taking extra 11-inch blush balloons. I would be taking the 5-inch, an extra jumbo, and all the colors of the sprinkles. Extra 260s, I would be taking my electric pump, my manual pump, extra glue dashes, extra pair of scissors. And am I missing anything? I think, and the sizer as well.
What are you using to stick the sprinkles?
I'm using the glue dashes. I don't know to which camera. Having a party, guys. Remember to use our code LUX. And then we also have another code, which is just LUXAN, L-U-X-A-N. But you can't combine the codes. LUX is just a temporary one. LUXAN you can use anytime. All right, should I add some? What do you think, Carlos? Should I add some down here? Should I just keep?
No, keep adding on top.
Keep adding on top? Okay, I don't know if I can reach, okay?
I'll bring you a stool. Can you, can this structure be okay outdoors?
Yes, yes, if you add it. And then like I was saying, you can always add blue dots on the last quad that's touching your jumbo. Place one blue dot on every single balloon, 11-inch balloon on the 9-inch quad to stick onto the jumbo.
Yes, this will get. This is gonna be available for replay. Says both of you are great teachers.
Wow, thank you guys so much. We appreciate your work.
What stand did you use? PVC and wood DIY?
Yes, it's a DIY wood and not PVC. It's an electrical conduit pipe.
Says
how, and I don't know what's the measurements, 3/4 or 1/2? No, it's 3/4 inside of 1/2. Mm-hmm. What's the name? Flange. Carlos has some ESL, you guys, so he sometimes mispronounces words.
Says I miss so much. This is going to be available for replay, don't worry about it. It says, is this for a party?
No, it's for you guys. I wish, honestly, because I had looked at the other teachable moments and they like already taught you guys how to do what I was gonna do this weekend. Columns, I have standard columns, so that's not as fun as actually doing a ice cream cone. So what I'm thinking, I don't know, I might use this for marketing. I do have, Carlos doesn't even know, but me and my mind were thinking this. That I might take this. We have an ice cream parlor like across the street from us, so I might just sponsor it and take it over. Is it okay with it? And then we'll just put our business cards there or our logo, so this doesn't go to waste.
So somebody asked, so how do I order it?
Order from Having a Party.
Just in general.
Having a Party's Instagram. And on their bio, they should have their link. Just go to their link. It's going to take you to their website. When you check out, when you're ready to check out, just add our promo code, LUX.
Somebody said on TikTok, I started my business because of you guys back when COVID hit. I took an online class.
Aw, thank you. Honestly, when you guys share that stuff with me, I really take it to heart. I appreciate it because I know that feeling. I also started my business because I got inspired by other balloon artists, but I don't think I ever told them because I was embarrassed. I don't think I've told them till this day. I'm like, they're busy, but thank you for sharing that with us. I'm very honored and humbled by the fact that we get to inspire a lot of other balloon decorators.
Somebody's asking, what colors are you using?
Four. Okay, so the bottom is blush, Qualitex, rose, Qualitex. The sprinkles are all Qualitex that I'm using. Wildberry, yellow, pink, white, pale blue, Caribbean blue, and lime green. Did I say orange?
Not sure.
I'm orange.
Sis, I need one of those gel taps. Will this need to be sprayed when finished?
I honestly, so every time I finish any balloon decoration, I know a lot of other people like use their air inflator to like remove lint and like dust if it's dirty, but I use a lint roller. I lint myself first just to make sure it's not like super sticky. I make sure to clean my balloons and then I'll add my shine. Use Mega Shine if I'm having a party, or I use High Shine. But if you want something that dries quickly, then I would just do Mega Shine.
For purposes of this question, I have to do a demonstration. So, excuse me?
No! You better not.
Excuse me, you're asking the question.
You guys are making me work.
So the question says,
I have to keep track.
How will you do this? No. Hi, can you show how to replace a pop balloon, please? Okay, so can you show us?
Yes. Okay, so I'm gonna count. So it's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So it's the 9th quad.
Oh, they asked for the jumbo too.
No, not the jumbo. I don't have time for that. Okay, so that was an 8-inch balloon.
Yeah.
So I inflated the one, the color that popped. So as you can see, when a balloon pops, there's still some left over. I don't rip that out. That's what I use. You probably want to zoom in on this. So I'm gonna size it to 8 inches. All right, I'm gonna tie a knot. It's very simple. Have a knot, and then just gonna grab the balloon that popped and tie a knot. And how would they know? Nobody's gonna know.
No one's gonna know.
There you go. So this is the final product and look of the ice cream cone. If you have any questions, let me know.
You want to do a selfie mode?
Selfie?
Yeah, like you read the questions. Right here. So, turn around.
Yeah.
Go over there.
Okay. All right. It was a complete pleasure to have been able to teach you guys how to do a cute little ice cream cone. You guys can do this for your kids for the summer. Offer this to your clients as a nice little extra touch. If you're doing, like I said, like Candyland or ice cream theme, birthday party, any of that. And obviously you can even change the colors. So if it's like a pastel theme, you guys can double stuff or use other brands that have pastel colors. The sizes that I used for the cone, those are, you're gonna have to look at the beginning of the video, and I gave them there. The jumbo is a 36 inch jumbo. Oh, I'm answering questions that were all the way at the top that you had already answered. Awesome, perfect, perfect. Well, thank you again. Feel free to reach out. Make sure to take advantage of that promo code. Thank you, having a party, for having Lux and Balloons. Be here with Teachable Moments. I love this shirt, it's so cool. Okay, let me see. Real quick before I leave, the height mentioned of the entire structure is about 8 feet tall, but the column itself is about 5'4". Awesome. Bye, you guys. Thank you so much. Make sure to rewatch this video if you joined a little bit later. In the beginning, that's where I went over all the sizing. And then as you continue to watch the video, you'll see how I did the 5-inch balloons and then the sprinkles as well, and how it is that I added the jumbo to the column. Awesome. Thank you, guys. Yes, don't worry if you missed the beginning. Just go back and watch this video, okay? Thank you so much. You guys are the best. I appreciate your time and your comments and your words of encouragement. And hopefully I will see you all soon. Bye.
Can you say bye to our YouTube family?
Bye, YouTube family. Hope you learned a lot. Make sure to follow us and subscribe and comment on all our videos so we could get more ideas of what you guys want to know.